Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up. It's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. Worship Your holy name. You're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. I worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship Your holy name. Come on, bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul, worship His holy. Worship Your holy name, Lord, I worship Your holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. Worship Your holy name, Jesus. worship your holy name. Worship your holy name.
Good morning to you all. Welcome as you join us at St. Andrew's Church on this special day, Mothering Sunday. So wherever you are, whether you are at home, at the office, whether with friends, family, or alone, welcome as we share in the love of God today. Mothering Sunday gives us the opportunity to give thanks to God for His love through the church and to show our appreciation for all mothers, for all women, indeed, for those who have cared for us over the years. Today we are here also to thank God for His great love for us through His Son Jesus Christ and through His church that has mothered us over the years. We remember that Jesus Himself grew up in a family, and so we understand and He understands the joys and the stresses of living in relationship with others. But at St. Andrew's too, we know that there are some of us which today may be a very difficult day for us. Some of us have lost our loved ones, our mothers, our sisters, people who have cared over the years for us. And so we are with you, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, we pray that you'll be comforted through the love of God. And so you join us as we give thanks for God. And if you have any of our service sheets, then respond in the words in bold. We praise you, God, for all mothers and women who have loved and labored as they cared for their children. Blessed be God forever. We praise you, our God, for all you who have wept sorrow and joy for their children. Blessed be God forever. We praise you, our God, for Jesus, born of a woman and nurtured in her love, and for Mary, a reminder of a patient waiting love. Blessed be God forever. And so as we come before a most holy God, a God who cares and loves us, and yet who calls us to be His children, let us call to mind our own failure to value the love of others, and our failure to love as Christ has loved us. So let's pause for a moment of reflection. Your life gave us life from conception, Lord, yet we failed as your children. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You call us to do good, yet we seek our own good. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. You hear us when we cry for help, and yet we ignore the cries of others. Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
have mercy. May the Father of all mercies cleanse us from our sins and restore us to His image, to the praise and glory of His name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray the prayer for the day. God of love, passionate and strong, tender and careful, watch over us and hold us all the days of our life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The psalm that we've chosen to be the first that we're going to read together is from Psalm 136, from verse 1 to 9, and then we will continue from verse 23 to 26. Please respond with the words, "His love endures forever." So give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the God of gods. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord of lords. His love endures forever. To Him who alone does great wonders, His love endures forever. Who by His understanding made heavens, His love endures forever. Who spread out the earth upon the waters, His love endures forever. Who made the great lights, His love endures forever. The sun to govern the day, His love endures forever. The moon and the stars to govern the night, His love endures forever. He remembers us in our low estate, His love endures forever. And freed us from our enemies, His love endures forever. He gives food to every creature, His love endures forever. Give thanks to the God of heavens, His love endures forever. For the God who cares so much and who sustains in our lives, from our mother's arms, even from our mother's womb, He has cared for us over the years, providing for us physical sustenance, spiritual refreshment. Today we thank God for Mother Church, and we are able to praise God for all who has cared for us, for all women, for all mothers. Let's hear something about God's own love for humanity from Psalm 20. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right path for His name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley, I will fear no evil, for You are with me. Your rod and Your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely, Your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
Amen.
What beautiful words that we read from the psalmist today. These are probably the best known psalm, in fact the best loved psalms that we can find in the Bible. And it's a psalm that many of us have heard it, whether at funerals or in church, or we read it in times of darkness. And it's this psalm that today we share on Mothering Sundays. There are two graphic pictures of God portrayed in this psalm. First, it is set God as a shepherd and we are the sheep. And then second, God as the host of a great banquet and we are the guest. This is a psalm that portrays the unrelenting love of God and His compassion for His people. It shows us that God provides for us. It shows that God secures our lives and that our provision and our security lies in no other place, in no other thing, not even in the environment, but in the hands of the God who loves us. And so the psalm is divided in two parts. From verse 1 to 4, the Lord is our shepherd. He is indeed my shepherd. And because he is my shepherd, I will lack nothing. Many things come from it, isn't it? First of all, God leads us as a guide with his loving hands. Secondly, he refreshes our souls. And thirdly, he comforts his people. Now God cares for us so much, like a shepherd, that he leads us into the good places of life where we will be provided for. And because of that, there will be no need, for we will be satisfied. Our hunger will be satisfied, and our thirst will be quenched. He is the God who will bring us beside the quiet waters, the place of refreshment, where our thirst indeed will be quenched. The result will be that our souls will be refreshed. We will be restored. In fact, because of God's love for humanity and for his people, even when we go and we sleep in the night, tired, labored, we will wake up refreshed because God is our shepherd. If we have friendship with this God, if we have a deeper relationship with this God, then when spiritually our energy feels depleted, we know how we can tap into God's loving power through prayer, through study, and through contemplation. But God is not always there only when the times are good. But when we get into darkest hours, the psalmist says, even in the when I walk through the valley of the darkest places, I will fear no evil. In times of our darkest valley, whether it's physical, death, or another destructive place, we have nothing to fear because our shepherd is with us, protecting us with his clubs and guiding us with his staff. Your rod and staff indeed will comfort us. But when our knees feel weak, when someone we love is facing terminal illness, and when we feel vulnerable, even when we ourselves become the patient, when things are out of control, when we feel the desperate circumstance about us, even the coronavirus, we do not fear because God himself will be with us. And so here we are. The Bible is telling us, the psalmist is saying that our circumstances, our environment does not determine our security and our provision. It's only in the hands of the shepherd of our life. From verse 5 and 6, the image changes because God now is our host to the great banquet that he throws for us. This is not a secret party that God is going to throw for us. Because of our relationship with him, God will indeed prepare a dinner in the presence of not only the world, but in the presence of our enemies. The experience and our experience of God's generosity will never be hidden. There will be food on the table, there will be anointed oil, and there will be overflowing cup. God will lavish on us more than we anticipate, or even more than we need. His generosity will overflow. This love is demonstrated when God gives us his one and only Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, who reapplies this image to himself, saying, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd who is prepared to lay down his life for you and I. So on Mother Sunday, and on the day when we give thanks for the love of our own mothers, we remember a love that goes beyond our human love. This is the love of God, demonstrating of in his Son Jesus, who laid down his life for each one of us. Not only here in this world, because Jesus will go on to teach us that In his Father's house there are many rooms, and he's going to prepare a place for us. And when he prepares a place for us, he will come and call us to himself. And so listen to what the psalmist says finally in verse 6. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And so on Magdalene Sunday, we have God's love that not only leads us into the quiet places of life, into the good places of life, into pastures to feed our hunger and to quench our thirst, but it's a God who also prepares for us a dwelling which in Christ Jesus we can acclaim, a new life, eternal life, life in the presence of God forever. This is the love that we give thanks for today. Happy Mother's Day to you, ladies. But we thank God for his great love and generosity for us on Magdalene Sunday. May this love be for you, for your family, as we endeavor to deepen our relationship with this God, the God who loves us in Jesus. Amen. So in the presence of a God who loves us so deeply and who has called us into a true and a deep relationship, let us come before him with confidence and pray for the world and for the church. So we give thanks. Let us give thanks for the deep love for God for each one of us, the God who gave us his son Jesus. And let us pray that he will help us to understand this love, to experience this love, that we may live as children of the living God. thank you for calling us your own. Great Shepherd, we thank you that you lay down your life for all humanity. We praise you that in your dying and resurrection, you bring us new life and victory over the evil one, victory over darkness. And so we pray for the people of our world. We pray for each one of us in these most difficult and challenging of times, that your hand will be upon us, and you reach out and you touch each person, each individual, each family, every home. May your peace rest upon us. May your healing hand touch and restore. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for victims of the coronavirus, and we pray that you, Lord, will continue your healing grace, that there will be restoration and healing. We pray for the medical staffs. We pray for all who are working towards bringing the situation under control. For all health staff, ambulance, 911 staff, please, we pray your Holy Spirit to grant wisdom and to prevent them from being infected, that they may look after your people. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for our government, for the Prime Minister, indeed for the Queen and her family, for the Cabinet, for all making crucial decisions in our world. Let's pray for God's protection over their lives. Let's pray for wisdom. Let's pray for a compassionate heart as they make decisions. That vulnerable in society will be taken care of. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our communities and for the elderly and vulnerable people especially. We pray that we may and we may stay away from infection. We pray that people will be comforted knowing that God is with them at this time. We pray the power of God to restrict the spread of this infection. We pray that even in these difficult circumstances, we look to Christ, our hope and our healing. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now we pray for men and women to be filled with good heart of compassion, to take this time as an opportunity to serve one another, even as Christ served us. May we all look for ways in which we can be a good neighbor. May we all look for an opportunity to be the light that shines in darkness. So may your Holy Spirit be upon your church, upon all people as you gift us to serve you, bringing our prayers together. We pray with confidence as Jesus has us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. In a moment, we are going to be praying for mothers and give thanks for them and bring our service to an ending. But before that, just to remind those of you who normally will worship with us at St. Andrew's that on Tuesday we have morning prayer. We will do that and using a YPA conference call or Zoom conference video. So look forward as we invite you to join us. But please know that we are praying for each and every one of you daily. The ministers of God will meet and pray for you. And so we ask you to pray for one another and never give up hope. God is with us. So let us stay on the course of faith for our great shepherd who provide and will protect us for his name and for his glory. So we're going to pray now. We can't bring you flowers today, ladies, but we can pray for you and say thank you for all that you do for us. And so for all those who have cared for people, those who have shown love for people, for all the women in our lives, and for the ladies we know, for all who have been mothers in every way to us, our own mothers, we want to pray for you now. If you have our service here, then please respond if you want to join us saying, thanks be to God. And so for all who care and for mothers, thanks be to God for their patience when tested. Thanks be to God for their love when tired. Thanks be to God for their hope when despairing. Thanks be to God for their service without limit. Thanks be to God. Thank you, God, for the love of all women and mothers. Thank you, God, for their care and concern. Thank you, God, for the joys they have shared for us. Thank you, God, for the pains they have borne for us. Thank you, God, for all they do and give to us through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters, it's been a great pleasure to worship with you this morning. You may not be a regular member of St. Andrew's, but you are a child of God, and we're pleased that you are able to join today as we celebrate Mothering Sunday and Mother's Day. Join us again next Sunday. We will be here, but also we will be discussing doing our Bible class on social media too. So when the time comes, we will give you more information for that. We are going to receive God's blessing. The Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord lift up his countenance upon us and give us peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us now.